Hi dancers, I'm Jojo from Ballet with Jojo and Adult Ballet Collective, and today I wanted to share with you my experiences with the dreaded imposter syndrome. Unfortunately, imposter syndrome is something that affects a lot of adult ballet dancers, and I've learned to just accept it as part of my adult ballet journey. I've experienced it on different levels, as an adult starting ballet for the first time, but also as an adult ballet coach as I decided to take the next step in my adult ballet journey to help other ballet dancers. So, imposter syndrome is basically when you feel like an imposter. You feel as if you are not competent enough as others believe you to be, or you feel as if you're a fraud. There's a range of negative emotions that sort of play into it. And imposter syndrome is completely internal. It's something that you experience by yourself. But that being said, the main thing to remember is you are not alone in your adult ballet journey. You're not the only one who experiences imposter syndrome. But why do we experience imposter syndrome? Like, let's get really down to it. So when you walk into a ballet studio for the first time, as an adult, you're so used to being good at stuff. You know, because you've had your whole life to learn these skills, but ballet unfortunately maybe was something you didn't learn. So you have to get used to being a beginner. You have to realize your value and you have to know that you deserve to be there. So I think a lot of people experience imposter syndrome because they feel like they just don't deserve to be there. They feel like they're in the wrong place. But really, ultimately, you made the choice to do ballet. So you have to identify and say, yes, I've made this choice. I want to be here. Yeah, maybe I feel a bit like an imposter, but I'm working through that. It's all about identifying what's going on in your head and then being able to move forward with it. I get a lot of imposter syndrome as well when I see other adult ballet dancers, and there's the next thing. You cannot compare yourself to anyone in person or online. You cannot compare yourself to anyone. Everyone is on their own unique journey. We all bring our unique experiences with us to our ballet journeys, which is actually what makes our journey so special. So we have to acknowledge that. It's not a bad thing. And as an adult as well, we all learn at different paces. So we need to stop using time as a measurement of our progress for our ballet journey, because we all work on our own time frame, okay? We're all different. So don't compare yourself to anyone. Even if you started at the same time, it's no comparison, because you don't know what the other person is going through and the other person doesn't know what you're going through. So basically, I guess what I'm trying to say is with imposter syndrome, it's in your head, but a lot of other people are also experiencing it. And that's one way that you can think about it and hopefully find some comfort in that, because you're not alone on this journey. And if you're ever feeling like an imposter, identify that you're feeling those negative feelings, breathe, allow yourself to reset, refocus your mind, focus on your journey. Focus on all the amazing things that you've learned and all the amazing things that you've discovered about your body and that your body can do now in ballet. Because once you start focusing on the positives, that's how you're going to experience your ballet journey. I truly believe that as adult ballet dancers, we get to choose how we experience our journeys. And while there, of course, are external factors, we're ultimately the ones that make the decisions of where we're going to take classes, who we're taking classes with, whether it's in person or online. So take control of your journey. Don't allow yourself to feel like an imposter. Acknowledge that that's happened. Breathe, reset, and move on. I really believe that a mindset is so important in an adult ballet journey, because it's how you experience things, like I said. So you really need to focus on working on a positive mindset in order to make the most out of your ballet journey. Because why did you start ballet? It's because you love it. It's because you find joy in dancing, okay? So you need to find that joy again. You need to find why you're going to class, why you're doing all this strenuous activity, okay? So there's so much to it, but ultimately, refocus your mind and know that you're not alone when you feel like an imposter. I hope that helped you today. If you have any questions or any comments, or you just need to talk, my DMs are always open to the community. If you like this kind of content, please like, comment, and subscribe. That would help me on my YouTube journey as well. And I hope to see you soon. Bye!